Hello students, in this video you will find preparation of copper sulfate crystal, copper sulfate pentahydrate in laboratory. Now let us see the method. First, preparation of copper sulfate pentahydrate. Method of preparation. Preparation of CuSO4.5H2O. This is called blue vitriol. We will use neutralization method. Neutralization method or decomposition method. Now here, reactants required. The reactants are, first, reactants. Either copper oxide or copper hydroxide, or you can use copper carbonate and dilute sulfuric acid. Next is their number 3 principle. Metal oxide, metal hydroxide, metal carbonate react with oxide, hydroxide. These are base, these are insoluble base, and this is carbonate salt of copper. React with dilute sulfuric acid to form sulfate salt and water. In case of carbon dioxide, there is release of carbon dioxide gas. Now let us see fourth point, chemical reaction. Chemical reaction. In the reaction, I am telling you first, these neutralize insoluble base, copper oxide. Next one, copper hydroxide, if you are taking. And next one, copper carbonate, if you are using. Any one of that we can use, plus dilute sulfuric acid, dilute form, remember, gives CuSO4 plus H2O, and CuOH twice plus dilute H2SO4 gives CuSO4 plus 2H2O. Now here next, copper carbonate, CuCO3 plus H2SO4 gives CuSO4 plus H2O plus CO2. These two, copper oxide, copper hydroxide, are insoluble base. The method is by reaction of insoluble base and dilute sulfuric acid. and here decomposition of copper carbonate by action of dilute sulfuric acid. Now let us see procedure or process. Procedure number 5. Procedure first point number A, take about 50 cc dilute sulfuric acid. Take about 50 cc dilute sulfuric acid in a clean beaker and warm it on wire gauze. Second point, add copper oxide or copper hydroxide or copper carbonate, one of that. Add slowly, a little amount at a time. Slowly means small amount in several installment with continuous stirring. You are adding that, then you have to stir that also with continuous stirring till no more of the substance dissolve in it, till no more copper oxide or copper hydroxide or copper carbonate dissolve in it, and a small amount of the copper oxide, hydroxide or carbonate settles at the bottom. Now third point, now filter the content of the beaker. Filtrate obtained in another beaker you transfer into the evaporating dish or china dish and heat it, evaporate the filtrate till crystallization point or till crystallization appears. That is what? Saturated solution of copper sulfate. Next point, now cool down the saturated solution or the hot solution of copper sulfate in the evaporation dish, cool it. On cooling that solution, rhombic blue copper sulfate pentahydrate crystals are observed in the evaporating dish or china dish. Now separate out these crystals by filtration and dry these crystals in between the folds of filter paper. This is the way you can prepare copper sulfate crystal or blue vitriol. Now in these reactions, one most important thing is there, prepared by these things. Here when copper sulfate crystal is obtained, copper sulfate during crystallization combines with water molecule to form rhombic CuSO4.5H2O crystal. That is formed there, and this procedure I told you several points, that points you will remember and you can prepare that. That's all for today. Again next video, next class I will tell you copper sulfate pentahydrate. Remember, this is also known as blue vitriol. This is a triclinic rhombic crystal, and whenever it is anhydrous CuSO4, this is white in color, and whenever it is pentahydrate, then its color is blue. Anhydrous copper sulfate, white, but hydrated copper sulfate pentahydrate is blue crystalline solid. Anhydrous CuSO4, grayish white amorphous solid. These are some important things which you have to remember. That's all. Thank you.